Hello everyone, and welcome back. I want to focus today's discussion on a few important topics: geology, the scientific method, and geological time. Today, we will begin discussing what geology is and its importance. Geology is the study of Earth and its history. In this field, geologists study the solid material of the Earth, including the interior and exterior surfaces, such as minerals, rocks, flowing water, on and below the surface, and any changes that have or are predicted to occur over time. As you can see, geology quite literally spans the entire world, and to infinity and beyond. I hope you're excited because we are about to delve into the Earth and its history in the next few discussions. Geology is an interdisciplinary science, and it's important to discuss the steps behind how a scientist explores a problem. This process is broken up into observations, hypothesis, and experimental design, and is a cyclic process. An observation is the catalyst to starting any research project and can be either a qualitative observation, which describes the properties or occurrences that does not rely on numbers, or a quantitative observation, which is reliant on measurements and numbers. From the initial observation, you begin to formulate a hypothesis, which is a proposed explanation of a phenomenon that can be tested. This can be a framework or a model to describe a natural system or a mathematical expression. Something to keep in mind is that a hypothesis needs to be tested. From here, the hypothesis can be tested to either support your hypothesis, or if it's not supported, then the hypothesis can be modified and the process can be repeated, hence why it's a cyclic process. When a hypothesis has been repeatedly supported by experiments, it can in time be accepted as a theory. There is a lot of confusion that surrounds a scientific theory, and it's not to be confused with a hypothesis. A scientific theory has been repeatedly tested and is supported by a significant amount of research and evidence. This means multiple individuals have extensively tested the hypothesis, and this has been accepted by many experts in the field, and it thus is accepted as a theory. This brings into light an important question. Why is it important to study the Earth? Well, hopefully, this should be a relatively straightforward answer. Earth is our home and where we currently live for the foreseeable future. Not to mention the amazing wonders and beautiful landscapes that surround us. But some other important reasons why we study the Earth is to better understand the evolution of the environment, anthropogenic impact on the Earth, and different ecosystems. To minimize and/or predict earthquakes, volcanoes, slope failures, and potential floods. These are just a small list of the reasons why we study the Earth. Before we begin delving further into geology, it is important to start at the very beginning. The Big Bang Theory. This theory is widely accepted within the field and takes into consideration countless amounts of observation, and this theory begins to explain the origin of today's universe. This idea was first proposed back in 1927 by astronomer Georges Lemaître, who is credited to be the father of the Big Bang, and proposed that the universe expanded as a result of a cataclysmic explosion and the universe expanded rapidly. As a result, tiny particles began grouping together, forming atoms, and over time, these atoms began coming together to form stars and galaxies. It is predicted that the universe is 12 to 14 gigaatoms, or billions of years old, with the Earth being approximately 4,570 megaatoms, or millions of years. Let's take, for instance, the planets in our solar system. Depending on how far away from the Sun determines the overall composition of the planet. Planets closest to the Sun contain more metallic iron and minerals that can withstand high melting temperatures, whereas the planets further from the Sun predominantly have minerals with much lower melting temperatures and water. The following table breaks down the planets in our solar system and compares distance from the Sun, the mean temperature, diameter of the planet, and the density. It also shows the planets which are predominantly rocky or metal planets in comparison to planets that are gaseous. The Earth's atmosphere has drastically changed over time. At the beginning, humans would not have been able to survive in those current conditions. However, over time, the Earth's atmosphere acclimated to being able to support oxygen-breathing organisms. When talking about geological time, this is equivalent to like a calendar event for the history of the Earth, and has separated into different sections, with the following graphic depicting Earth's history as a spiral. When dealing with geological time, it is separated from largest to smallest into eons, which are then divided into eras that are then divided further into periods, epochs, and ages. I hope you have enjoyed today's discussion on geology and the scientific method and the Big Bang Theory. Until next time, have a wonderful day, and in lieu of my normal ending, I figured this time I'll go out with a bang!
1, 2, 3. Cheese.